Praise the Lord. As I'm cleaning up some posts on the Might Work Supernatural blog, I came across an old post that I posted in 2009. And the name of that post is, Every Stronghold is Broken. When I began to think about that prophetic word that the Lord had given me that morning as I was praying at the women's prayer, I thought about the women there who missed that blessing. Even though we consisted of a small group of women, at that time it was six of us, and I made seven. And each woman, as they feel led, would take turns and pray. And I have learned by the Holy Ghost since I began attending that women's prayer to always ask the Holy Spirit to pray through me. Because I don't know what needs to be said. I don't know what's going on. He knows everything. So when he prays through me, then that gives me the surety that everything is going to be all right. Because after all, he is God on this earth. And he knows what traps the enemy have set for us. And only he can make intercession through us to the Father through Jesus Christ, to stop Satan attacks his plan. So I learned to trust him, and I asked him before I pray to pray through me. Now, everybody do not do that. They come with their own list of prayers, what they're going to pray about, but that may not be what is needed at that moment. And at that particular moment, in that house, in that church where we were attending, there was a stronghold there. The Holy Spirit revealed to me as I prayed, and he made intercession, he revealed that that church had a religious spirit. So, as I began to allow the Holy Spirit to pray through me, he began to make intercession. And I noted that the intercession that he was making, and he was assuring the women that was there, and the pastor's wife was one of those women who was there. So what the Holy Spirit began to say to everybody is, every stronghold is broken. And as he was saying, he said it three times, and he said it with such power and might. And each time that I said, every stronghold is broken, I noticed that he had me to take my hand and I would clap. And I knew in the spirit realm that clap was a clap that destroyed destruction and plans of the enemy. And then the Holy Spirit began to say, he began to point out what that stronghold was. He said the religious stronghold is broken. The financial stronghold is broken. Family stronghold is broken. Because that was what was going on in that house. That spirit of religion and that financial stronghold and individual having marital problems. But you know what, dear heart? I learned from that. When the Holy Spirit makes intercession through us, we must also believe that we have received what the Holy Spirit is saying. It's up to us to receive him or not. So then the Holy Spirit continued to say through me, because the Holy Spirit knew that there was three women, the pastor's wife plus the two women that always followed under her instead of keeping their eyes on Christ Jesus, they followed her. The Holy Spirit knew that they was reject, that spirit in them was rejecting truth. So they was looking at, they only could see me. You only can see the vessel who God used. Because God is a spirit. And if you are tuned into the flesh, into the fleshy physical realm, you cannot see the things of God. So they only saw me. So quite naturally, they thought that was me saying those words. So the Holy Spirit began to tell them, ask them, know you not that I am the Lord that healed thee? Fear me, for I am he who can destroy body and spirit. He says, Satan is under your feet, so act like it. You know, we quote Satan is under my feet, but how we let the world know that Satan is actually under our feet is when we act like he's under our feet. Then the Lord says, tread upon his head. Why? Because we seated with Christ Jesus in the heavenly places. So that's why Satan is under our feet, because Satan is here on earth. And if we're seated with Christ Jesus in heavenly places, that makes Satan under our feet. So the Lord said, walk on him, tread on him, act like it. Act like Satan is under your feet. And then the Lord said, again, every stronghold is broken. Every stronghold is broken. Every stronghold is broken. Then again, the Lord knew they was looking at me, and he said, why are you looking on Terry? As if these are her words. Take your eyes off her. She is on the instrument that I am using. Judge the words that are coming from her mouth. Are they not my words? You see, dear heart, that is the subtle trap of the enemy. Is that when God is speaking, we can, if you tune into the physical realm only and only can see with your carnal eye, you will accuse the person of being the one who are saying those words. Because that's how you see the individual. You can't see God. So therefore, since you can't see God and you judging those words coming from the individual, you will end up not receiving that which God has given you or is saying to you. And that is what happened to the pastor wife and the two women that follow her. They was not set free that day. Because they did not receive the word of the living God, because of them looking so much as if it was me saying those words. Dear heart, I pray today that you do not make that error. Keep your eyes fixed on Jesus Christ. Learn to know his voice. When you learn to know his voice, it does not matter what instrument or which instrument he used to come through, because he always going to use a human vessel to speak and to act through. But if you know his word, if you know him, he is a spirit and he's true. And if you know truth, you know him, regardless of the instrument he used, you know that's your father's voice. You're not looking on the instrument. You're not looking on the instrument, because your eyes is fixed and tuned to Christ Jesus. But praise be to the Most High God, that morning, there were three other women. Their eyes were fixed on Jesus Christ, and they heard God's voice. And do you not know, dear heart, those three women, especially this one woman, when she came into the women's prayer, she was so bad. I could see the spirit of heaviness on that woman that it turned her skin darker than what she really should have been. That spirit was suppressing her and had depressed her. Why? Because she was having family problems. She was having family problems. And she needed to be set free. And do you know she received God's word? And do you not know God broke that stronghold? That stronghold had to let her go. Because the Holy Spirit was moving powerfully. And she came to church that Sunday morning. She was light as a feather. You could see her complexion had came back to normal. She had this big smile. She was praising the Lord. She was just jolly. She was happy. And she came to me and said, Sister King, I am free. And I said, honey, you look free. Praise the living God. She received the words of God through the vessel whom he chose to speak through. And so, and likewise, the other two ladies. And, you know, I just wanted, you know, to share that with you because I feel in my heart that is the mistake many of us are making. We are tuning our eyes on the vessel in whom God used, and maybe we don't like that particular vessel. We have our other favorite vessel that we like for God to pour his word through, but then when it comes down to someone I really don't care too much about, that I really truly don't believe that they're a child of God, no way, so I'm not going to hear them. You miss God big time, but yet still you crying out to the Lord, help me, Lord, help me. And the Lord, if he can get through you, he'll say, honey, I tried. You rejected me. You say, well, when did I reject you, Lord? You remember Evangelist King? You didn't believe she was an evangelist. You didn't believe she was my child. You call her a witch. You said she don't know what she's talking about. God didn't call her to do what she's doing. God is not speaking those words through her. That's her. He said, I was speaking through her, but you rejected her. But you didn't know you was rejecting me. Dear heart, set your eyes on Christ Jesus. His words are spirit, and they are truth. Know his voice. And when you know his voice, a stranger you would not follow. Because a strange voice can work through those who you think you can trust. So keep your eyes fixed on Jesus. Don't allow the enemy to steal your blessing. Hear him. Cry out to him. Say, Holy Spirit, help me to know my Father's voice. I need to know my Father's voice, and then a stranger I will not follow. Regardless of the vessel whom the Lord chooses to use, help me to know his voice. Allow me to become familiar with you, Lord Jesus, not come familiar with a human vessel or a human person and say, well, I know I can trust them, because that would be the very one, Lord, that Satan would use to deceive me. But help me to know your voice, and then a stranger I will not follow. And Holy Spirit, I ask you to teach me also how to pray. And when I pray, to trust in you, that you make intercession through me, because you are the intercessor. Help me, Holy Spirit. Help me. In Jesus' name. Dear heart, I just praise and thank God for him. Other people may not believe in you, but Jesus Christ believes in you. And that is all that matters. When the Lord Jesus have not forsake you, he have not left you. He's always here. I mean, he is so compassionate that he loves us so much. You know, if sometimes we could just see the way he looks at us. You know how a woman have her baby for the very first time. She just look at her baby with such compassion and love and in her eyes. And there's nothing she would not do for her baby. And I'm talking about a true mother. Well, Jesus look at us all the time that way, dear heart. He loves us so much. He loves you. He loves me. Dear heart, feel free to go to our blog at thechildrensmic.blogspot.com. Visit our website at thechildrensmic.org. And I just wanted to share this audio spiritual nugget with you, because I just felt led of the Holy Spirit to do so. Dear heart, I want to thank you. And be blessed in Jesus' name. Shalom.